Write 5 and 1/4 as an improper fraction. And an improper fraction is just a pure fraction where the numerator is greater than the denominator. This right here, it's not a pure fraction. We have a whole number mixed with a fraction, so we call this a mixed number. So let's think about what 5 and 1/4 represents, and let me rewrite it. So if we're talking about 5 and 1/4, 5 and 1/4. And you can literally think of this as 5 and 1/4, or 5 plus 1/4. That's what 5 and 1/4 represents. So let's think about 5. 5 is 5 holes, or if you're thinking of pi, we could draw literally 5 pies. We could draw 5 pies. And let me just cut up the pies from the get-go into 4 pieces, since we're dealing with fourths. So let me just cut up the pies right over here. So that's 1 pie right over there. Let me copy and paste this. Copy and paste. So I have 2 pies, and then I have 3 pies, and then I have 4 pies, and then I have 5 pies. So this is what the 5 represents. 5 literally represents, so let me circle all of this together. That is the 5 part right there. That is what 5 literally represents. It represents 5 whole pies. 5 whole pies. Now, I have cut up the pies into 4 pieces. So you can imagine each piece represents a fourth. Now, how many pieces do I have in these 5 pies? Well, I have 4 pieces per pie. I have 4 pieces per pie. 4 pieces per pie. 4 pieces. Well, let me just write it here. 4 pieces per pi times 5 pies is equal to 20 pieces. Or another way to think of it, since each piece is a fourth, this is also equal to 20 times 1/4. Or you could just write this as being equal to 20/4. So we have 5 whole pies is equal to 20/24. Let me write it like that. 20/24. Or we could write it as 20 over 4. I've kind of done the same thing twice. So that's what the 5 pies represent. 20/24, or 20 pieces, where each piece is 1/4. Now the 1/4 right here represents literally one more fourth of a pie, or one more piece of a pie. So let me draw another pie here. So that is another pie. Cut it into 4 pieces. But this 1/4 only represents one of these pieces, right? This is one of the 4 pieces. The 4, the denominator, tells us how many pieces. The 1 tells us how many of those pieces we're dealing with. So it's just this one piece over here. That right there is the 1/4. Now, if we write 5 and 1/4, we just saw that the 5 right here is 20/24. So we could write this. So we could rewrite this. So let me write it like this. 5 and 1/4. 5 and 1/4 can be rewritten as, this is the same thing as 5 plus 1/4. 5 plus 1/4, which is the same thing as, we just saw that 5 whole pies is the same thing as 20/24. 20/24. And to see that these are the same thing, you literally just divide 4 into 20. You get 5, and nothing is left over. So 5 is the same thing as 20/24. And then this plus 1/4 is the same thing as plus 1/4. So if I have 20/24, and I add one more fourth to it, how many fourths do I have? Well, I have 21. I have 21. Fourths. Or another way of thinking about it, this 5 is, so this right here is, that right there is 20 pieces of pie. And you can even count it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. But a quicker way is to say, well, we have 5 pies, each of them have 4 pieces, 5 times 4 is 20. This 1/4 right here represents 1 piece plus 1 piece. So total, we're going to have 21 pieces. So we have 21 pieces, where each piece is 1/4. So you could say we have 21 times 1/4, or 21/4 pieces of pi. However you want to think of it, but we've solved the problem. We're at an improper fraction. We've written 5 1/4 as an improper fraction. Now, I've gone through great pains to give you the intuition of what 5 1/4 means, but there is a fairly straightforward process for getting straight to the improper fraction. If you have, let me color code it. So if you have 5 1/4, to convert it into an improper fraction, you're going to keep the same denominator. So you're going to have the over 4 there. But your numerator is going to be your numerator of the fraction part before. So it's going to be 1 plus your whole number times your denominator. So 1 plus, or actually let me do it the way I tend to think of it. What I do is I take 4 times 5, so let me write that down. 4, and I want to color code it. 4 times 5, and then to that I add this numerator. So I literally do 4 times 5 plus 1, and which is, so this is equal to 4 times 5 is 20 plus 1 is 21. And that's over 4, so it's 21/4. And although this is kind of a fast way to do it, we're literally doing the exact same thing that we did here in a kind of a slower way. We're saying, OK, 5 wholes is the same thing as 20/4. So you take 5, and I figure that out, times 5 times 4. And then I have one more 4th there. So 4 times 5 plus 1 gives 21.